In a previous screencast, we determined how long it would take to fill a coffee cup given information about this coffee urn. In that problem, we assumed steady state. However, in this problem, we're interested to determine how long it would take to drain the coffee pot if we left that nozzle completely open. So in this problem, we have an unsteady state Bernoulli equation. So with any problem, we should probably start by labeling our diagram with the information given in the problem. We have a 2-foot tall coffee urn that dispenses coffee through a nozzle that is 5 inches above the table surface. The diameter of the urn and nozzle are 10 inches and 0.5 inches respectively. And we want to know how long it's going to take to drain. At this point in the problem, we need to make our assumptions to help us solve. Now, to use the Bernoulli equation, we're going to assume that the flow is inviscid, that there's no viscous effects. We're going to assume that the flow follows specific streamlines. And lastly, we're going to assume that it's incompressible. Now, obviously, since it's unsteady state, we're not going to assume steady state condition. This allows us to write the simplified form of the Bernoulli equation, where the pressure at point 1 over the specific weight, and we'll say point 1 is the nozzle, point 2 is the liquid level, plus the velocity at point 1 squared over 2g, plus the height of point 1 is equal to some constant, which will therefore be equal to the same at point 2. At this point, we're going to assume that the coffee pot is open to atmosphere, and we know that the nozzle is going to be open to atmosphere, so we'll cross out our pressure terms since they will just be equal to each other and therefore atmosphere. We're also going to say that our point 1 is a value of 0, so we'll cross that out. In rewriting this equation, we get the following. Now we know at point 2, this is just going to be the height of the fluid that's a function of time, so we could plug that into our equation. And there's one last assumption we're going to make to simplify this problem. That being that the velocity at point 2 that's changing with time is going to be much less than the velocity at point 1. And we make this assumption because the diameter at point 1 is much less than the diameter of the coffee urn, or that of point 2. So we say that the velocity 2 is therefore negligible here, and we can model the velocity at point 1 as a free jet. So at this point, I think I know what you're thinking. Is that we said this was an unsteady state problem, but now we've just taken the Bernoulli equation, made it steady state, and gotten a velocity at point 1. Well, although we've said that the velocity 2 is much smaller, it is not equal to 0, and we could write the velocity at point 2 as a differential. It's going to be the change in height with time. And we call this quasi-steady state. It's not quite steady state, but we're going to assume that it's pretty close to it. Now, when we do this, we take into consideration the continuity equation, which basically says that the mass flow rate at point 2 must equal the mass flow rate at point 1. And if we assume an incompressible flow, we could rewrite it as the following. Now, I've rewritten these as volumetric flow rates, where it's the velocity times the cross-sectional area. Now, we know we could calculate the cross-sectional area at point 1, given the diameter of the nozzle, and the cross-sectional area at point 2, given the diameter of the tank. So we plug this into our areas, and we take our differential that we've rewritten for point 2 and our free jet analysis for point 1. At this point, I've written little r and big r just so I don't start plugging in numbers quite yet. So little r is the radius of the nozzle, and big r is the radius of the coffee pot. So if I separate out the variables so we get the differential on the left side, and I've grouped the variables on the left side here as 1, since these are all constant. So we're going to go ahead and call k, and that's going to be equal to negative 2g r squared, little r squared over big r squared. And this allows us to rewrite it and integrate as following. We need parameters to integrate from, so we'll say some height initial to some height final, and time of 0 to some time t. So integrating this, we're left with the following. And since we're interested in the time it takes, we're going to rewrite this so time is on the left side. And I get the following. At this point, again, I haven't plugged in numbers because this gives us an equation that, depending on any cylindrical system that looks like this urn, and we could follow the same assumptions, we could plug in the two radiuses, our gravitational constant, and our initial and final height to figure out how long it would take to get there. So in this specific case, let's go ahead and plug in some numbers. You can see I've used a large radius of 5 inches, an initial height of 2 feet, and then we see that the nozzle is at approximately 5 inches. We did not write the height of the actual nozzle because we know that as the coffee flows, it will stop when it reaches this point. So let's go ahead and assume 5 inches. So the 2 feet minus 5 inches gives us the 19 inches. and then the radius of the nozzle being 0.25 inches. A time of 15.5 seconds. So recall for this unsteady state problem, we assume that the flow is inviscid, incompressible, and we used a quasi-steady state approximation to get V1 and the continuity equation to get V2. This gave us an expression to calculate the time to go from one height to another in a cylindrical system where we could make these assumptions. And plugging in the values for our coffee urn, we got 15.5 seconds. Now, one of the problems, obviously, that would come up with this is that this diameter of the coffee pot's not quite that much larger in magnitude than the diameter of the nozzle, and we assume 5 inches, where we do know that there's going to be a little bit of difference between the bottom of the nozzle and where the coffee is going to stop pouring. So some things to consider next time you're doing this kind of analysis.